Oh, what? 7:42? What rubbish? Are you kidding me? Hi, what's up you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video for today's video. It's finally time for the much awaited IKEA haul. Ever since I went to IKEA, you all have been just asking for the haul video. So here I am with part one, which is the gamla edition. Literally feels like I've picked up every single ways that IKEA had to offer. Every single one of them. Like, I just look over here and I'm just like, what were we thinking? Like, इतनी तो जगह भी नहीं है घरों में, दोनों घर में लाके भी इतनी जगह नहीं है जितने हम गमले उठा के लेके आए हैं. तो दिस इज पार्ट वन द गमला एडिशन एंड देयर इज आल्सो सम अदर डेकोर. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द होम डेकोर एडिशन. व्हेन वी वेंट टू आइकिया वी वेंट लोकी क्रेजी. वी शॉप्ड फॉर एवरीथिंग. लिटरली 85,000 का बिल आया था. मेरा पूरा का पूरा घर का सामान मैंने खरीद लिया, राइट फ्रॉम फर्नीचर टू डेकोर टू इवन पिलोज एंड यू नो किचन वेयर एंड एवरीथिंग ऑर्गेनाइजर्स. सो द पार्ट टू ऑफ माई आइकिया haul will have the organizers and the kitchenware and crockery and all of that that I got, like the adulting stuff. This is all the pretty stuff, but also this might just be the second last video for me. It's the last video that I'm shooting in this backdrop. So this might be the second last time you all see this backdrop, because I've shot another video which you will see in the next week. But that'll be it you guys. Then you will not see this headboard again, you won't get to see this backdrop again, and we'll be in Sara Squad Studios officially with all of this IKEA decor up there somewhere, which I'm so excited for. I mean, I'm so emotionally attached to this room that it's going to be difficult to say goodbye, but it's just a step ahead. And I might just get very emotional right now, so we'll head on right into the haul. If this is the first time you've come onto my channel and you have no freaking idea who I am, then hi, I'm Sara. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. We keep it super fun and fresh over here. So if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then take a moment, hit the subscribe button, join the Sara squad. I'm sure you'll have a great time here. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, let's dive straight into this. I'm also going to be uploading this makeup look on YouTube Shorts, so stay tuned for that. If it's already up, I will link it for you in the description box. I'm not trying to go price-wise because I honestly don't remember all of the prices, but let's start with the cheapest one, which you must have seen in every single IKEA haul. Agar tumne kisi ke IKEA haul mein nahi dekha hai na, to wo insan barabar IKEA gaya hi nahi hai, because ye gamla na har jagah rakha hota hai. Like this vase, this clear glass vase is legit every two steps you will walk in IKEA and you will see this, and it's only 100 rupees. So like when my dad saw it, he was like, do teen utha le. And actually my mom picked up three of this, so we have three vases like this exactly right now. Don't even know where it's going to go in both of the homes, but we have them. And these flowers actually just come in the same counter as them, and they are 50 rupees each. So actually IKEA fake flowers, I did not like the quality of them, to be very honest. They're very average quality. If you've seen my Crawford Market haul, if you've not, I'll link it for you on top. But Crawford Market flowers are so much better than IKEA flowers, and they are much more cheap over there as compared to IKEA. Like ye to sirf 50 rupees ka tha ek phool, but baaki ke phool I did not find anything worth it. Like ek lambi si dandi hogi aur wo 600-700 rupees ki hogi, and it's not worth it, and it's not even that pretty. So you can definitely avoid the fake flowers over there, but the vases are to die for. Like this is just the warm up. Okay, we're just getting started. This is also a very cute vase for 100 rupees. It's definitely hands down worth it. You should get your hands on this. It's so super pretty. You can fill water in it and, you know, put stones or whatever and make it aesthetic, sand even. Next I got these, and I got this in one more rose gold. So we have again three of this. I will make sure to flash the prices for you on the screen. They are like a narrow flask shape. They come in different reflex colors. There's silver, there's rose gold, and there was also gold, but we didn't pick up gold. We have two of rose golds now and one of silver, and this is that same 50 rupees flower. So it's very cute and a nice accent element. Next I picked up this, which is a ceramic pot, and it's a nice pink color. If I'm not wrong, this was also 100 rupees, but I don't remember very clearly. Prices are not been mentioned on the product itself, so I will have to look up on the website and mention it for you. This is a ceramic planter, so you can plant a real plant in it. I would love to plant like a snake plant or a money plant in this. We shall see later when I go plant shopping, but this is an exciting. Another couple of cute affordable vases that I picked up were these. These are stainless steel metal sort of, which have this gold reflex material. I think these were also 100 rupees each if I'm not mistaken. And I got two of them. One of my personal favorites was this one. It has this mirror gold reflex material on it. And I love the shape of this. Like a nice thick dense bunch of roses would look so beautiful in this vase. I don't even think this was very expensive. Don't remember the exact price, but it definitely wasn't a very big hole in the bunch. I think this was all for the affordable vases that we got on IKEA. Now diving a little steeper into a little more unique but also expensive category. The first thing I got in that was this. I'm telling you, I've picked up every single gamla vase or flower holder there was in IKEA. And this was 657, the prices mentioned on this. It's basically like, you know how Beauty and the Beast made, there was this rose inside this, and as the time passes the rose keeps wilting. So this just reminded me of that so much, and I felt like, you know, the Disney lover in me had to get this. And I will definitely keep a rose only inside this. Maybe not a real one, I'll have to keep a fake rose, but I'll definitely keep a rose inside this because it's so Beauty and the Beast. It literally reminds me of that movie. And my mom also picked up one of this, so again we have two of these now. I definitely should have checked what mom was picking up and what I was picking up, because we both ended up picking up so many of the same items. But it's okay, I mean, now kya hi kar sakte. Next I got this. I found this very unique and different because it has this teacup sort of an appearance. Not teacup, what is this, teapot sort of an appearance to it. It has this navy blue stripes on it, so it gives a nice sailor vibe. Again, a nice green luscious plant would look so good. It's not very big also, so it can fit in any small nook. Next I got this. This is a white, off-white sort of a ceramic vase again. This was also a little expensive. Like, these are the steeper prices for the vases, but this is so classy. I mean, it's so classy. I can just imagine my pampas grass sitting in it and blooming all the way, and looks so aesthetic and so pretty, so my vibe, and very elegant. And that's why I had to pick it up. The common one I've seen is this pink vase. I got two of them again because mom and I picked up two, and I've seen so many people have this vase, and it's because it's so beautiful and unique. And at the same time, it's only around 600. And another one I picked up specifically for my pampas grass was this. So this is also such a unique shape because it's cylindrical on the top and then it like curves down to the bottom, and my pampas grass would look so gorgeous in this. It also has a holographic shift to it. I don't think the camera is picking it up, but these are the two off-white ceramic vases that I got specifically for my pampas grass. Another vase I got, don't know where I'm gonna keep it, don't know which element. I think pampas grass would also look really good with it, but maybe greens and whites would look really beautiful with this gray vase. It's a very unique shape. I don't know if I'm gonna take this into Sara Squad Studios or if I'm gonna keep this in this home itself, because it's more the vibe of this room than it is of anything on top. But we shall see. We shall see where we decorate this baby. That was actually it for all of the gamlas. Abhi itne sare gamle leke aaye, to humko usko pani dalne ke liye bhi kuch lena tha. So we got this cute watering can. I mean, it's so cute. I'm sure I will use it for watering my plants as well, and not just for aesthetic reasons, because I picked it up with the intention that I'm going to use it in an aesthetic corner. But now that I have so many planters and I'm going to have so many plants, I might as well take care of it with this cute watering can. So I absolutely loved it. I'm telling you, cute karke humne bahut kuch utha liya hai IKEA se. Ye bhi dikh gaya to ye bhi utha liya. These are basically like three fake plants. I think three of them were for 100 rupees. Oh, what? 742? What rubbish? Are you kidding me? No, dude. It can't be only. There's no chance. There was some sort of a discount on this for sure. I would never pay 742 for three fake small plants. I'm telling you, no, fake plants in IKEA were a scam. They were a scam. But I don't think I was scammed so bad. I really hope not. I'll really have to check my bill for this. 742 I paid for this. No, dude, it was very cheap. I remember seeing it. I think udhar ke prices na ispe kuch aur tha. This happens at IKEA. I don't know if I mentioned it in my video, but jo boxes pe tumhare furniture item honge, you don't have to mind that. You have to mind what is written on the board. So that is what's the actual price. I'm definitely sure I've not paid 742 for this. But these are basically three fake planters. I don't know if it's gonna fit in any of this, but they come with plant, like they come with their own vases as well. So you can keep it in a bathroom or, you know, small corners in the house. That was all for the gamla edition. Now a few other decor items that I picked up. The first one was this. This is basically like a photo frame strip, like a film strip. So I found this really cute. I don't remember how much. I think this was 1000 rupees or something. something. But I think it's really cute. It's very, very tall. You can fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 photos in this, and it's a great way to have all your friends and family in one place, which is my idea behind this, because I don't plan to put multiple photo frames in my home, like photo frames like I've done with this wall in my home. If you've seen this room's tour, you know this wall has all of my friends and family's photos, but I didn't want to do the same thing in my new home as well, so I decided that I would go for something like this. It has a hole over here so I can hang it in one of the nooks and have all of their photos nicely lined up in one place itself, all my loved ones in one reel. Picked up some few more photo frames, but mostly this I'm going to use for like aesthetic corners with quotes that I love written on them and not really photo frames. I picked up the flimsiest, cheapest photo frames they had because I didn't want to spend a lot. Plus, you know, with glass, it's scary, like dusting karte samay gir jata hai, and these I want to keep like against the wall, so that's why these are like plastic frames. They're very, very inexpensive, like 100 rupees, 172 rupees. This is, I don't know how much, this is like 172 again. This is a little thicker and it has a broader frame to it. These both are different in size but same in price, because this quality is really flimsy whereas this is a little more sturdy. And lastly, I got a super massive frame as well. This is Fisk Bow in 14 to 50 centimeters. It's great for a nice massive painting or a huge photo. I'm really not sure of where these photo frames will go, or you know what I'm gonna put in them, so for that you'll really have to stay tuned for the final tour of the Sara Squad Studios. But that was it for the IKEA decor haul. Mostly everything that I got was vases, because I feel like they're a great find at IKEA. Every single one of them is so beautiful, so unique, and something you don't see very often at your local plant vendor. So I can just take this to my local nursery and ask him to fill these all up with beautiful plants. So just put fake plants and make them aesthetic in corners. So it's a great way to amp up your space, and I think at IKEA they were the best finds ever. Apart from that, in decor I was not really liking much. Like, I just feel like it was very expensive for the price of it, and I did not even feel like I needed it, so that's the reason I did not pick up. What I'm very excited to share with you all is also the crockery haul, because crockery at IKEA, so super cute and also very affordable when it comes to dinnerware and crockery. So stay tuned for that haul as well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. I'm sure you're very excited to see the Sara Squad Studios come to life. I am as well. So don't forget to share this video with your other friends and family, and we can all be waiting for the Sara Squad Studios to come to life together. Thank you so much, really, genuinely, for all of the love you've shown all of my videos. I read all your comments and it really warms my heart of how engaged you all are in the making of the Sara Squad Studios. You all have been there with me right from the start, seeing my journey. You all saw this room transform, and now you all are seeing me and watching me transform my entire home, and it's so surreal for me. It gives me anxiety, it makes me nauseous at times, but it just grounds me at the same time, knowing that you all are all watching over me and are there for me and supporting me in every step of the way. And I'm so super grateful. I'm very emotional because this is my personally last short video in this backdrop, and I'm gonna miss it. I'm really, really gonna miss it. Okay, you guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Dr. Sneha Haridas. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you wanna be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you. Mwah.